We are now ready to learn how to classify stereochemical environments in a molecule, the so-called topic relationships that we discussed in the previous webcast. We want to conclude whether a pair of groups are homotopic, enantiotopic, diastereotopic, or constitutionally heterotopic. Now, there's a couple of ways that we can go about doing this, and the method that we're going to learn here is known as the substitution test. And in the substitution test, we start with a molecule, and we're going to ask whether two groups in that molecule, how they're related to one another. And what we're going to do is we're going to first replace one group with an achiral test group Q, and we're going to draw that structure out, having done that substitution or replacement. Why do we choose Q? Well, Q is not a symbol that shows up in the periodic table. And so anytime we draw a structure with a Q in it, we know it just represents some achiral test group that will help us distinguish the two groups in question. Once we've generated the first structure, we then start with the original molecule, and we replace the second group with the test group Q. And so now, at the end of this process, we have a pair of structures, and each structure has one Q in it. The next thing we do is to go ahead and decide how those new structures, those new isomers, are related to one another. Are they homomers, enantiomers, diastereomers, or constitutional isomers? If the structures, the new structures that we've generated are homomers, then the original groups in question are homotopic. If we've generated a pair of enantiomers, the original groups are related as being enantiotopic. If we've created a pair of diastereomers, the original groups are diastereotopic. And if we've generated constitutional isomers, the original groups are constitutionally heterotopic. Let's apply this classification scheme to some of the molecules that we looked at in the previous webcast. We had asked the question, how are these hydrogen atoms and pentanoic acid related to one another? And so if we go ahead and apply the Q-test, we start with our original molecule, and we replace one of those hydrogens, say the one in front, with a Q, and we draw that structure shown here on the left. Now let's draw a second structure, starting with the original molecule, and replace the hydrogen atom in the back with a Q. We've generated a new pair of isomers, and we want to use our classification scheme for isomers to decide how these are related to one another. You'll find that if you try to superimpose the molecule on the right with the molecule on the left, the only way you can do it is if you first look at the mirror image of the structure on the right, and then you can superimpose every bond and every atom of these two molecules together. And that would be the criterion for enantiomers. And so these two hydrogen atoms in question are related as enantiotopic. In the bottom case, we go ahead and we do the Q-test, first by replacing the hydrogen atom in front, the one we're interested in with Q, and we draw that structure there. Now we're wondering about the hydrogen atom in back. We create a new structure, starting with that original and replacing it with a Q to generate the structure shown here. If we try to superimpose these two new molecules on top of one another using any aspect of symmetry, rotation, reflection, translation, we'll find that we can't do it. There's always one configuration that cannot be superimposed for the molecule that's on the right with the molecule on the left. That's the criterion of diastereomers. They have the same connectivity, so they're not constitutional isomers. They're non-symmetry related isomers that have the same constitution. In other words, they're diastereomers, and so those hydrogen atoms in question are diastereotopic.